Today we're going to make us a Cajun meatloaf. And I was going to smoke it outside on the smoker. But the weather's all bad and raining and storming and lightning. And we don't go out around metal objects outdoors when the weather's like that. This way we ain't smoking it, boy. See there? Yeah, right. It'll be okay. So I got some bell pepper, some celery, some onion. This purple onion, that's all I had. Some garlic. Got some leftover hamburger buns. Can y'all see all down there? Alright. And we got some evaporated milk. And we're going to open, look down here, boy.
Right.
We're going to open the evaporated milk up and soak that bread down with that, like this here. And get it all nice and soft. I also got some 80-20, come on down here, boy. Also got some 80-20 ground chuck right here. And some bacon. Some thick sliced hardwood bacon, smoked bacon. And we're going to apply that to the exterior after we mix all that stuff up in there. In there, boy, in there. Now to add some additional flavor to this meatloaf, we're going to add some oregano. Alright? Now you can add chili powder to it. You can add any damn thing you want. This is going to be kind of an Italian-Cajun mixed blend. That was thyme. A little bit of thyme in there. If you want curried meatloaf, put curry powder in it. It's a salt. Just gonna put it in this plate. Meatloaf needs a little salt. It needs some pepper. And we're gonna mix all this together and form a loaf. Now, what I gotta do now at this point is take these garlics and whack them down. Alright, so all these rough cut veggies, salt, pepper, that stuff going in there. Here goes some of the onions. I ain't gonna put them all because I may have too many. And here go the garlics. Can't have never too many of them. Trust me, boy. Alright. So now let's get the grind meat in there. Grind meat right there. I ain't gonna use all of this, but I'm going to use most of it. Okay. So I got all this mixed up. And this is something that you don't want to do to hamburgers. But you can do to meatloaf. And don't put no oatmeal or goat meal or nothing like that in your meatloaf.
Your turn.
Okay. You see the consistency? Don't need nothing else. This is 80-20 ground chuck. And it's got plenty of stuff in it. Look, come on. Trying to move the camera without getting grease all over everything. My hamburger meat. Now, meatloaf.
Yay!
Alright?
Yay! Yes,
it's gonna shrink all up. So we're gonna form a loaf. And we're gonna go bake this off in the oven. And I got some extra onions left over. So I'm gonna put some on this side. And on that side, and the escapees can go over there, and this is going to make an excellent Cajun meatloaf. So I'm out of slap you mama, I'm just going to use salt and pepper, put a little bit on the outside, like that and like this here. I just put a couple thick pieces of sliced bacon on there. You can enclose the whole thing in bacon if you want. We're going to go bake this off in the oven, covered for a little while. At about 350 for... I'm using a convection oven too, so it's going to be about 350 for about an hour. And then we're going to take it out and uncover it and then put some sauce on top. I'm going to show you how to make that. Night, boy. So this is the special sauce. Ketchup. Like that there. Some brown sugar. Some pepper. Alright, there's the precise measurement of the brown sugar. And I can see that's way damn too much. Damn it, boy. And let's put a little bit of Horsesher sauce in there. Alright. We may go ahead and put a little mustard too. Let me taste it first and just see. It's going to make a glaze on top is what it's going to do. We're going to put a little mustard in there too. I'm going to pour that on top of that meatloaf. And we're going to go ahead and put a little bit of this basting sauce on top. Matter of fact, we're just going to dump it all on there. It's going to make like a little glaze. A Cajun glaze. Glossy. If you want to say so. Alright. We're going to put this back in the oven, uncovered. Alright, Alex, here's what you do. You put the recommended amount of water, butter, margarine, whatever you're going to use. You turn the fire off, boy. Then you pour the milk in, the recommended amount. This recipe that I'm making calls for the whole damn box of Idaho Spuds mashed potatoes. Now it say on the instructions, do not whip. Just stir it in. We're just gonna mix this in. Like that down.